Hi everyone, today we are going to see about the design options on loaders. So already we have seen enough about the boost up loader, which is a type of absolute loader, and whatever program already we have discussed on our assembly and in our loading is all about linking loaders. So today we are going to see one more other design option, which is linkage editor. So today we are going to concentrate on this session about linking loaders and linkage editors. So what is linking loader? A loader that do linking and relocation every time it is assembled, it is called linking loader. What is a linkage editor? A linkage editor produces a linked version of the program and it stores as a file in the library. And whenever it is required for execution, the file is brought from the library before the execution, and a simple relocation loader is needed to load this file into the memory for execution. Let us see the architecture diagram of the linking loader and a linkage editor. You can see that in a linking loader, whenever the object program is called for execution, the relocation linking happens and it is brought into the memory. And in the second diagram, when you see, a linked version of a program is stored on the library, and whenever it is required, from the library a relocation loader could be used to load that and used for execution. So from this architecture diagram, you can understand the working of both the linking and linkage editor programs. What is the application of the linking loader and the linkage editor? How it differs? So linking loader is often used in programs which require recursive testing and development. So it is often has to be the code has been modified and then been executed. In that circumstance, if you use linking loader, it will be very beneficial. When will you use linkage editor? A program which requires a less modification and it is will be rarely it will be changed, then we can go for a linkage editor. So the next question is, in linkage editor, can we do some modification in the linked version of the program? Yes, we can do. So if the library file has been stored, the linked version of the library file has been stored in the system for execution. Before execution, if you want to include a new file, or you want to delete a control session, or you want to change the name of any control session, all could be done on the library files, and we have seen the commands to do that. So the next slide is all about that. You can see that you can include a file, rename a file, change a file in the linked version of the program. So you could always change whatever changes you want to perform on a linked version of the program. So, but it is not often. So that is the difference between the linking loader and the linkage editor. Next, we are going to talk about dynamic linking. So how these three different loaders work? In linking loader, the linking happens every time of reassembling. Whereas in linkage editor, only during execution, before the file has to be loaded into the memory, the linking happens. Whereas in dynamic linking, the file has been uploaded in memory and it starts the execution, at that time dynamically the linking happens. So that is the next topic we are going to discuss.